What would be the most exciting discovery in our lifetimes? To me, it would be finding life elsewhere. Even a discovery of microbial life would be an incredible discovery, not even just for our lifetimes, maybe for all of humanity. If we discovered something like bacteria in our solar system and it represented a second origin of life, a second genesis, that would blow the minds off religious scholars, academic scholars, philosophers. It would be taught in grade schools that life can originate by natural chemical processes. A second genesis of life in our solar system greatly improves the likelihood that the universe is teeming with life. If there are conditions like Earth, which we expect there to be, perhaps life takes hold very early there and has an opportunity to evolve into the complexity we see here.
We're sort of like the next generation of astronauts, but here on Earth, all the work that we're doing is sort of helping us eventually try and find life. We're gathering all the tools, trying to find what sort of biosignatures we should look for, chemical signatures. My research focuses on studying extreme microorganisms living in soda lakes to hydrothermal vent environments to understand what sort of organisms could exist on other celestial bodies in our solar system that contain oceans. One part of my research is cultivating a really interesting microbe called Methanocalculus neutronophilus. Learning about their metabolisms sort of gives us hope and a very good idea of what we could potentially find in other oceans. They use hydrogen and carbon dioxide to make methane, and the Cassini probe found that Enceladus also had hydrogen, carbon dioxide, and methane. So we're hoping that by studying this organism, it's a good model for what could potentially exist on Enceladus.
I'm involved in the search for life in the solar system. I'm trying to develop a framework for using chemical species that can be detected by spacecraft around these icy ocean worlds in our solar system. So one of the things I do with my experiments in the lab is I take them to very high temperatures and then I quench them in cold water. That process is meant to mimic the circulation of ocean water on these icy ocean worlds into rock, where it can be heated before it is brought back and expelled into this icy ocean. So the experiments I'm conducting here may help guide us in targeting chemicals for the spacecraft to try and taste. And those chemicals could tell us what kinds of life could be supported within the interiors of these icy ocean worlds.
I often think about how the organisms that I'm cultivating or the projects that I'm doing could actually be life that we could see on other celestial bodies in the solar system. And that's an extremely exciting part of my research, and it sort of motivates me every day. I think the speed of science right now is at a pace that we could see life being discovered in my lifetime.